Hey people, it is Wednesday, March the 15th. The time is 6:09 in the morning. It's currently a chilly minus 5 degrees Celsius, but with a wind chill of minus 12 degrees. And I'm walking along Gerard Street East here on the east side of downtown. And I thought I'd take a walk around mostly the east side here on this chilly early morning. And recently daylight savings time came into effect, so what we gained in light later in the day, we lost in light early in the morning. So sunrise today won't be until 7:30 a.m. So for those who do have to get up early in the morning on a regular basis, you're going to be making the way around in the dark for the time being. Eventually the sunrise will come earlier as we get further into the year, but we're in for some darkest before the dawn type stuff in the meanwhile. And even though it is quite bitterly cold this morning, later on today the temperature is expected to get up to a relatively mild 5 degrees Celsius with a lot of sunshine. So I'm making my way north up Church Street. Usually in my early morning walks, I tend to walk around the more southern end of downtown most of the time. So I thought for this one I'd venture a bit further north. Eventually I will make my way back to the south again. And it's crossing Carlton Street, a couple of streetcars. 505 Carlton. That one runs 24 hours. It's the Maple Leaf Gardens Loblaws. So maybe I'll take us up through the Church-Wellesley village. It looks like the Loblaw store here is just getting ready to open for the day. See some workers already getting things prepared. the good old Hair of the Dog, long-standing local establishment. So with the mild weather expected today and tomorrow as well, I'm hoping a lot of these crusty snowbanks start disappearing. Coming into the heart of the village here. As far as I can remember, I've never walked through Church-Wellesley this early. Up ahead is Wellesley Street. I think I'll head over to Yonge along Wellesley. Certainly never seen this intersection so quiet before. Church-Wellesley subway station. The trains are running already. They start, I think, at around 5:30 a.m. or somewhere around there. I think the only time I ventured up this way so early in the morning was one time in 2019 when my channel was still relatively new. And then another time doing one of my super early live streams, of which I've only done a couple of those. Let's head north on Yonge for a bit, and then I'll probably go over to Bay and head south again along Bay. There is a night bus network in Toronto. After the subways stop running around 1:45 a.m. or so, there are some bus routes that do run throughout the night until the morning. Quite a few, actually. I think the Toronto Night Bus Network is the largest such bus network in North America. And the moon is looking pretty neat right now, looking straight down Yonge Street. Got some nice crescent moon action. Maybe I'll just go up one more block and then I'll make my way over to Bay. Look down Isabella Street. A number of 24-hour restaurants around the area. I did do a recent video walk around the east side of downtown, seeing how many 24-hour establishments I could pass by in 1 hour-long video, and there were quite a few just on the east side of downtown. Walking west on St. Mary Street, and we're gonna make our way over to Bay. I don't often walk down St. Mary Street, so I'm kind of just seeing some things for the first time here. At least in this direction, anyway. I think I walked along it in the opposite direction. Alright, here is Bay Street. So Bloor Street is just a few blocks up to the north. Let's walk right in the street. That's something I like to do sometimes when it's so early, before there's any traffic, or at least not much anyway. Wait for another break in the traffic if there is one. See if we can walk right down the center of Bay Street. We might not get the chance. The traffic will be starting to pick up quite a bit between now and 7 a.m. This might be my only chance. There's a median of sorts here. pulling a bit of a walking man dude here. It's a local character who used to walk down the middle of the streets singing to himself with an imaginary microphone. I haven't seen him in over 6 months, so hopefully he's all right. Toronto's newest superhero. See, they've finally taken the tarps off of this government office tower that they've been refurbishing for the last several years. It's completely covered in white tarps. Almost forgot what it looked like underneath there. You can see one of these smaller ones is still covered in the tarps over here. This whole complex is getting refurbished and brought up to modern standards. Wellesley Street again. Haven't seen too many dog walkers this morning so far. keep passing these little plaques walking along. A new paradigm for Bay Street. Underground in the public realm is a continuous tree ditch. Above ground are open planting areas with precast curbs surround and trench covers with leaf gates through which runoff rainwater is channeled. Well, all right. Grenville Street, and this is the sort of backside of the Toronto Police Headquarters. Fronts onto College Street, which is the next street down. But I don't see any traffic coming, so I'm just going to head across. That crescent moon again. College Street. least now that I'm walking south, the wind is blowing behind me, not directly in my face. The mighty aura. And this will lead you up into College Park. This ridiculous snowbank here. How long will it take for that to disappear? We need some majorly warm weather and a lot of rain to get rid of that. You got your Bitcoin, you got your Dogecoin, and you got your Ethereum. All available here, 24 hours a day. And Litecoin also. It's crossing Gerrard Street. Do I see the first hints of possible sunrise over there? Still a good almost hour away. Wind is pushing me along here. Can make out the top of the CN Tower. At Elm Street. I think that guy ran onto the bus without paying, just to get out of the cold. more glowing sky off in the distance there. What's that saying? It's all is darkest before the dawn. Man, what is happening here with the blocked off sidewalk? Police line. Okay. Here's Dundas Street. The south is the financial district, but I think I will head over to Yonge again here along Dundas. If the sky isn't brightening up, then Yonge and Dundas will do the job quite well on its own, brightening everything up. If you ever look at some nighttime aerial views of downtown, it's pretty obvious where Yonge and Dundas is. It's just a giant shining beacon, sort of, when viewed from above. Not a preacher in sight. It's probably the best time to walk through Yonge and Dundas. interesting ad there. Looks like the former Foot Locker store has finally been leased. That has sat vacant for quite some time. It is a pretty huge space. I'm not exactly sure what that is. It says coming soon. Looks like a bunch of plushy toys in the sign there. Well, whatever it is, it's better than a big vacant space right in the heart of downtown Yonge. Toronto Eaton Center. About to pass Shooter Street, and then after that is Queen, and that's where I'm going to be wrapping up the video. So I'll start my closing remarks now. I hope you enjoyed another early morning walk around downtown. This time we ventured to the north and saw some parts of Yonge Street at this hour that I haven't walked along in quite some time, as well as Bay Street. So I hope you enjoyed. If so, let me know down in the comments. Or if you didn't enjoy, let me know down in the comments. Either way is fine with me. And be sure to like, share, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And also be sure to hit the notification bell. That way you won't miss any of my videos. And if you'd like to support the channel, there are links in the description where you can do so via PayPal, as well as via my merch store. There's also a super thanks button right down below if you'd like to support the channel that way. And you can find me on Instagram under K Continuum. Well, good morning to him. So thanks for watching, and be sure to keep checking back, because as always, I will continue.